U.S. President Joe Biden now looking at his options after his term ends. Biden famously announced in July that he was stepping aside from the 2024 presidential race following pressure from party leaders. At a White House reception celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month, Biden jokingly asked Hollywood star and successful businesswoman Jessica Alba for a job.
And by the way, Jessica, thank you for the introduction. She's an actor, producer, advocate, author, and she knows how to build companies. Jessica, if I'm really good, maybe you can get me a job in this. God love you.
Dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go facing this House Quad Committee for the first time. The panel is investigating illegal drugs, POGOs, and the massive killings during the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. POGO incorporator Cassandra Ong, Go's alleged lover, Sual Pangasinan Mayor Liseldo Calugay, and former Iloilo City Mayor Jed Mabilog are also present at the hearing. Mabilog surrendered to Philippine authorities last week after his seven-year self-exile in the United States. He fled the country in 2017 after then-President Rodrigo Duterte tagged him as an alleged narco-politician. The former mayor firmly denied this in his speech during the inquiry.
Bigla na lamang naisama ang mga pangalan sa PRRD narco list ng Administrasyong Duterte. Isang listahan naglalaman ng mga pangalan ng mga kilalang public official na di umano ay sangkot sa illegal na droga, mga paratang na walang basihan, at kahit kailan ay hindi naman napatunayan. On August 28, 2017, I received an unexpected call from former PNP Regional Director Bernardo Diaz. He invited me to meet with PNP Chief Ronald De La Rosa, now Senator, at Camp Crame, Quezon City, at noon the following day. The next morning, on August 29, I arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport at 10 a.m., ready to proceed. But then the call started. First, they moved the meeting to 3 p.m., and then by 5 p.m., it was delayed again, this time to 6 p.m. At around 5 p.m., a PNP colonel called me and, in a voice that sent shivers down my spine, literal po yun, warned me not to go to Camp Crame because my life was in danger. The fear that had been simmering now erupted. Soon after, at 6:32 p.m., my wife, Marivic, received a chilling text from a PNP colonel's wife, "Do not proceed. There are 20 men surrounding your house, and if you go to Camp Crame, they will kill you." The terror was paralyzing. I couldn't believe it. I was not and never will be a drug protector. I don't know personally, nor did I benefit in any way from any illegal drug personality in Iloilo or anywhere else.
Lawmakers once again assert the inquiry is not meant to attack anyone but to expose the truth in aid of legislation. Former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque earlier called the QuadCom a kangaroo court, accusing lawmakers of power tripping. This after the committee once again cited him in contempt, with Roque now an object of a, or subject of a police manhunt.
Ang sisiyasat na ito ay hindi para magpakitang gilas o mag-usig, kundi para makapagpasa ng mga bagong batas.
Power to conduct investigations in aid of legislation is a fundamental function of Congress enshrined in Article 6, Section 21 of our Constitution. This is not a mere privilege, but a duty to the Filipino people. Congress is empowered to investigate, to compel testimony, and to demand documents when it is necessary to fulfill our legislative mandate. These inquiries are designed to shed light on matters of public interest, to recommend policy reforms, and ultimately to legislate for the welfare of the nation.
The panel will also invite the son of former President Davao Representative Paulo Duterte in the next hearing after he sent a letter to the House expressing intent to raise questions to the resource persons.